Good afternoon.
Do I have an open statement or do you
have to fire it out?
You want to start with questions?
Yeah. Ready to roll. You all ready?
All right. We do have the microphone for questions.
Is that a recruit over there?
Coach Tager, Chris Knee from Knowles 247. What has the last 2 weeks been like for you getting the board in order, recruiting guys, trying to close on early signing period types? Just what has the schedule and the workload been like?
It's been go. You know, when I got the job, I first thing tried to get out and see as many of our committed players as I could, get to introduce myself to them and get to know them, talk about our vision, our program, and where we want to go with it. You know, so just go, and not necessarily try to salvage a recruiting class, but introduce myself to them and seeing if there's something they want to be a part of as well.
How do you kind of strike the balance there? You've got the guys who Jimbo brought in who are already committed, ready to sign. You've got some new guys you tried to go out and get. How do you strike the balance between those two?
Well, like I say, you'll see the ones that committed because there's a reason why they committed here. You know, and you want to see those guys, but also share your vision with them to see if that's something they want to continue to be a part of. You know, and you can never stop recruiting guys until you get them signed and a big part of it. I mean, I wasn't necessarily trying to sign a full class in the early signing period. I don't think that was going to do us any justice in trying to build our program like we want to build it. Evaluate some guys and see that those are guys that fit what you're trying to do. And then try to bring in some guys that you know that can. And then with a lot of the kids, they want to see who we bring in as a staff, which is fair to them, it's fair to us, because we got to make sure we're bringing the right kind of guys in here that's going to fit what we're trying to do as well.
Coach Wingate, tell us in prep, how difficult was it to go into players' houses not knowing, not being able to tell them who the next staff was going to be?
I wouldn't necessarily say it was different. You know, difficult. Just go in and be honest with them. You know, and I told them I'm going to get the very best coaches from Florida State University and guys that's going to fit what we're trying to build here. You know, it's really important that I get the right fit and get coaches that not only got a great coaches but a great mentors to our players. You know, so I don't think it was necessarily difficult. It was just, again, explaining to them our vision and what we're trying to do. And again, I think they understood they just got here. And one thing I told them, I'm not going to rush to get a coaching staff here to try to salvage a recruit class here midway through. We still have February to go, but I'm going to get the right guys that's in here to help us build this football program. And there's a lot of coaches out here that want to be here. It's just a matter of getting the right guys.
Willie, Tim Lenefeld, Seminoles.com. You said a couple weeks ago that you were looking forward to being able to recruit for Florida State rather than against Florida State. Just I wonder how those first 2 weeks have gone, going in and meeting guys with Florida State rather than trying to convince people maybe not to go to Florida State.
Say that question again.
Like say when you were at South Florida, you said you would have a hard time recruiting against Florida State. Is it different now being on the side?
Oh yeah. You know, it's great. You kind of get to the front of the line now when you walk into the school. You know, there's no more parade waving anymore. You know, you get to the front of the line, and that's pretty cool. Again, to me, it's going to be different because you're not necessarily chasing guys. There's a lot of young men that want to be here. It's just finding the right fit for Florida State University. You know, and it's great that so many young men out there want to be here now, finding the right fit and the right guys for who we want to be as a football program. Got to do a great job of evaluating.
Coach Joe Reedy, Associated Press. How much of a challenge is it, though, with the early signing period, because you don't know how many guys are going to be left during these last 6 to 8 weeks?
Well, I think the challenge with the early signing day is when you have turnover, when you have this coaching change like we've had here, it's challenging because as a coach, you want to evaluate your current roster, you know, and I've been able to do that a little better now. I guess that's a challenge to try to get, if I wanted to get everybody into early signing period. But for we have February, you know, in the past, you know, when you have this transition, you still have the rest of December and you have January to do those things. And now you don't have that. So, again, it's not like we were going to sign a full class anyway. We only have about 16 to 18 guys that we're going to sign anyway. So we got to make sure we get the right guys, not just filling the class just to fill it. That's not going to help our football program going forward. We got to get the right guys.
LandherdSimples.com. Was one of the goals trying to get guys to hold off on signing until February so we could get a chance to get to know you, get to know your staff, and so you can get a little bit more time with them?
Well, I think that was fair to the young people and fair to us too. You know, get our staff in here and evaluate the guys to begin to make sure they're the right fit for what we want to do. But I think it's fair to the young people as well that they get to see that, and I get to build a relationship with them along with our coaches. You know, having a month and a half to do that would be good and fair to everybody. You know, then you have some kids that they were going to come to Florida State University regardless. They wanted to be here. And again, you love those kind of guys, but those guys that's on the fence, it's fair to them to get to know me and get to know our staff and see if that's what they want to spend the next 4 or 5 years of their life. You know, so it's so important for the young guys. This decision is so important for them, and again, it's not fair for me or anyone in there to go make them make that decision right now. You know, so, and it's, like I said, it's also fair to us that we get everybody in here to be able to evaluate those guys as well.
Coach Corey Clark with WarChant.com. Did you have a relationship with Jaden before the last 2 weeks? How did that recruitment come about where you landed such a big prospect so quickly?
Again, in Florida State University, there's a lot of guys that this has been their dream school. And this was a dream school for Jaden. You know, and so reaching out to him, he was very, very excited that I reached out to him. And he was so excited to get down here and see Tallahassee, see the university, and meet some of our people here. And along with his brother has been a Florida State fan for a long, long time. I mean, even more than Jaden, you know. And so it was just kind of like a family affair. Folks that really enjoy Florida State, love Florida State, and want to be a part of. So once he got down here and got around some of our players and seeing the campus and everything, he just felt at home and felt it's the place that he wanted to be.
Willie Brennan Sano with Knowles 24/7. The first guy that you saw, the first recruit when you came here, was Amari Gaynor, I guess. Why was he a priority, and how important was he to kind of get him secured?
He's a legacy kid, you know. His dad played here, and he's a kid right here in town, you know, so it's kind of obvious. You know, you're going to go see that. I can ride a bike over to his house and see him, you know. But and he's a kid that really loved Florida State and done a great job of trying to salvage the recruiting class. The kid is awesome, you know, just talking with other recruits. And when you meet him, and you just see the glow in his eyes when he talks about Florida State University. And get you fired up as a coach. It's like, this is the right guy to have here. So being a legacy kid, first and foremost, is big time. And just his passion for our university is huge.
Michael Langston with WarChant.com. Coach, talked to a lot of kids, and they, you know, talk about the culture here, you know, the official visits, but talk about your excitement level of this class that you have already, early signing period, and even the guys that haven't signed yet. Obviously not talk about them in name, but just talk about the vibe you're getting from these kids.
It was great. You know, we had a big recruit weekend last week, and I thought all those kids really enjoyed themselves. Like you say, there's some guys that haven't signed yet that will sign. We have today and tomorrow in this early signing period, and then you got some guys that's not going to necessarily sign the national letter of intent, but they're signing Grand 8 and still be here and midway through. So there's a lot of young men that love Florida State. They wanted an offer from Florida State, and again, it's just about finding the right fit. I'm excited about the ones that signed already. I think we have some really good football players that we've said and done, we're going to have one heck of a class and some guys there that's going to get in the fold.
All right, Coach, we're going to go to the phone. Matt, go ahead.
Matt?
Yep. Hey, Willie. Kind of big picture here. What have you thought of the first early signing period? What's it like to not like?
I think when you establish as a staff, it's probably a good thing when you have kids committed and this is where they want to be. They can get it over with. I think with all the turnover that goes on around this time, it's not necessarily good for the student athlete, you know, because they're getting recruited by coaches that they build relationships with. And then I think we all know during this time is when a lot of the coaching changes happen. So kids are signed and then coaches leave, and it's not necessarily fair to them throughout that that process. So I think, again, it's good for the university and the coaches, but not necessarily for the prospect that's deciding to go to the school because they really have a great relationship with the coaches, you know. But they're also kids that they're going to go to the school regardless if the coach is going to be there or not. So that's a different story. But I just think with all the turnover that happens this time of year, it's not necessarily good for the young people.
And then you mentioned that you expect only to find probably 15 to 18 this class. What's kind of the rationale behind that?
Scholarships. You only can have so many. How many scholarships we have? We have a lot of guys coming back unless some guys leave early, but that's how many we have to give out unless you can find a couple more for me. I'll take them. You know, but that's pretty much it.
Thank you.
Willie Safadine, Orlando Sentinel. Wanted to ask, what are some things you're kind of doing to getting to know the players that are on the team right now? Are you at practice with the roster in the back of your pocket? And are you having kind of one-on-one meetings? What's that kind of thing?
Have you been out of practice, Coach? You just described what I'm doing. I have a list of numbers and get their names and being able to watch them and evaluate those guys. But also just pulling guys aside and just talking to them, you know, where they're from and family background and what they're majoring in. I think it's unique here now because I get to see these guys practice, and that hadn't been the case before. You know, but it's cool. I mean, to sit in your office and the guys come by and hey, coach, are you busy? You know, no, never too busy for you guys. You know, but being able to just sit down and talk with them and seeing again the glow in their eyes and excitement of coming to talk to me. And usually, guys are a little intimidated. The new guy, and you don't know what coach is thinking, but these guys have been great.
Sure, it's a lot of names in your bank the last 2 years.
Yeah, usually I'm good with the last name, you know, or I call them buddy until I find out. But like I tell them all, they want me to remember their name. They got to do something. You know, so, but it's coming along. I'm getting there. Actually, I can get there a little quicker now because of again watching practice and seeing guys. I know when you see guys make plays, you tend to know those guys' names a little better.
You're a quarterback guy. There's not a quarterback early in this class.
I'm a football guy.
What are some traits that really like you look for most in a quarterback? The first things you look for?
I think first and foremost is leadership. You know, you got to have a guy that's going to have great leadership and the guy that does things the right way. You know, and I think from a football standpoint, you can see the skill sets and see if the kid has it or not. He can throw the football. Decision making, you know, is really important. You know, he was tough, smart, highly competitive kid. some of the great recruiting class. A big part of this is that guys start to recruit each other and they start to build that relationship with each other. You know, we get a lot of credit as coaches, but if you look behind the curtain, you'll see that these young men do a great job recruiting each other and building a relationship within the class. And a lot of guys want to play for each other because of the relationship that they do have. And, again, that's kind of how recruiting has changed nowadays. And, it's great to have someone like that, and especially someone like Amar, who's around here all the time. I told Amar he can take me around, show me how to get places, and I asked him questions, you know, rather than me answering questions from him. He's answering questions from me, but it's great to get a legacy kid that understands Florida State University, what it's all about, and have his dad, Herb, again, understand what Florida State is all about. You can see that within his child.
Coach, Ira Schofield with WarChant.com. We spoke to Doc Patrick the other day, and he mentioned that you've had a conversation with him about his future, and he said that he spoke to Royce Freeman. Did you help facilitate that? And do you feel like you're kind of re-recruiting some of these older players who might be considering their future plan?
I think I've been re-recruiting the entire football team. You know, I've been recruiting my tail off, recruiting newcomers, recruiting our current guy, recruiting coaches. It's been recruiting. But I think Jacquez did that on his own. You know, I heard about it and asked him about it yesterday, actually. Asked him how did that go with Royce, you know, because I know what kind of guy Royce Freeman is. And when he asked me about it and Royce coming back, I told him Royce felt like he was a first-round talent and he wanted to show and prove that he could be a first-round talent, you know, but he also wanted to make sure that he had the program going back in the right direction. You know, Royce was at Oregon as a freshman when he played the national championship game, so he's seen the best. You know, he's seen the bad part of it, and he didn't want to leave on that note, so he was, you know, Royce was a different young man. He was a great young man that cared about his teammates, cared about the university, but also cared about being the best that he could be, you know, and so sharing that with Jacquez. And I thought it was great that he reached out to him. You know, I thought it was smart that he reached out to him. And hopefully, Roy shares some things with him that can help him with his choice when it comes down to it.
Coach, I just wonder some of your impressions from watching practice and seeing some of the players and talent that are here. Are you excited about what you see, encouraged to see some things that you can maybe change or make things different? Just what are your overall impressions?
I'm excited about all those things you said. You know, some of the guys here, some of the changes that's going to be made, and where we can go going forward. We do have some really talented football players here, and we're going to do some things differently. And I'm excited about that as well. But watching and seeing guys run around is get excited. I can't wait to really put my stamp on it and get rolling. But more importantly, can't wait to continue to get to know these guys. That's the most important thing. Once we get to know each other and the talent and the things they can do in football, they're going to take care of themselves. But it all starts with relationships. And they don't know me. I don't know them as well. And I'm excited about having that opportunity to get to know them over the next however many months as we continue, as we build the program like we want it.
This is the fourth time you've put together a staff. Is this the normal timetable for putting together a staff? When would you want a full staff in place?
Whatever I did is I never had a timetable of when I wanted to get it together. I just wanted to make sure I get the right guys. That's, I think now I'm doing it a fourth time. You live and learn and early on and my head coaching career probably was too fast to hire a staff. Necessarily hire the right fit for what we're doing. And as you know, you kind of live and learn. I think it's, the fit is more important than the guys and what they know. You know, because they can know a lot, you know, fit and it just messes everything up. You know, so it's a big time job for me, and I got to make sure I get the right fit here and passionate people that want to be here, but also understand the Florida State way of doing things. That's really important to me, and really important to me that I get coaches that can be great mentors to our players. players need that more than anything. That's got to be on the top of the list when hiring our coaches. They're going to be great mentors to our players.
Well, we've seen players playing some paintball, getting to wear some different uniform combos. The music at practice has been blaring. Why are those things kind of important to you for the players to kind of have and experience and to lighten things up? Why are those things kind of important for you to, in this first month of your tenure?
Well, I think this job, I think this game, and just life in general is tough as it is, you know, and sometimes we forget to have fun doing what we're doing. And I think it's really important that our guys are having fun doing this. They put in a lot of work. They spend a lot of time with each other. And sometimes you get so caught up in winning, you forget to have fun with each other. And, I want to make sure our guys are having fun, but also working and competing in everything we do. From a music standpoint, you just see these kids nowadays. You can walk down the road, they got a headphone on, they got earphones on. You know, they like music, you know, it kind of helped them focus. It's like the craziest thing ever, you know, but it's the world we live in now. And the first day, and I need some juice too. I mean, I can't be bored, but the first day it was kind of dead, and it was hard to watch. And I needed it more than they did, you know, but it was. Great to see the difference the next practice, just how they were flying around and starting to seem like they were having a little fun and flying around, but more importantly, it seemed like they were enjoying practice. You know, and it's crazy how something that small can just make a difference. Again, it's not necessarily going to make you play better, but if it's going to help you focus and get you to play with some passion, some enthusiasm, and great effort, then we're going to do whatever we can to make sure that our guys are giving us that. We need some more country music out there, though. Not enough country music out there, so should we have some of that?
Coach Kevin from WC TV. When you're coaching on the field, I feel like you have a decent degree of control. But when it comes to recruiting, and you're watching these 17, 18-year-old kids pick a school, what's it like for you as a coach to kind of have your fate, the team's fate, rest in some of these kids' hands, depending on what school they pick?
As a coach, again, I think if we're going to do right by the prospect, then it's just being open and honest and selling your program and selling your vision to them and not necessarily trying to force anything on them or force them to make a decision. You know, I don't think that's the right way of doing it. It's just sell your program, sell where you want to go with the program and what you are as a person and how you see them and how you see them being a fit in your program and hope they make a decision off of that. Never been the one to pressure any kid. I don't think that's fair or right to that young person because this next 4 or 5 years of their life is the most important 4 or 5 years of their life. I'm a big believer that when these young people turn about 22, 23 years old, they're pretty much who they're going to be the rest of their life. And it's so critical that we help them become the man that they want to be. And sometimes you don't get that. And they need that more than anything. So often that these kids become great football players and take football away from them, they're in trouble or something bad happened, they haven't learned anything else. It's our job as coaches to make sure that we help them with that.
Coach, I know that the players are focused on Southern Miss in this bowl game. With DeAndre Francois not being able to play, are you able to talk to him, maybe give him some of your playbook stuff to kind of give him a head start since he's not preparing for that game?
No, I haven't. They want it, you know, and like I told them, there's plenty of time to learn that playbook right now. We got some unfinished business that we got to take care of. And with Francois, we had a chance to talk and talk about vision, talk about what I expect of him as a quarterback on the football team. And right now, I just want him to be around this football team and be with his teammates and be supportive. With his teammates and finish the season. And it's really important that these guys go out and finish the season the way they know they're capable of and give us some positive momentum going into the off season. It's going to be a long time since we play a football game, and we want to make sure we're going out on the right note. So I want to make sure those guys are focused, more importantly, on each other and being a team and being there for each other. And I want him to, even though he can't play, but being out there with his team, being around him and being encouraged
job at Florida State or Oregon or some of the jobs you've had, that there are plenty of people who would love to come join you. How difficult is that? Some of them may be friends, former colleagues, to decide who's the right fit?
I guess it's not necessarily difficult at a place like this because you have so many talented guys that want to be here. So you know from a coaching standpoint, they can coach. Again, it's just found the right fit for what I see and feel for our football program. And once you get to sit down and talk with them all, and you hear their philosophy and their values and what they're all about, you can kind of get a sense of whether or not that guy's going to be a good fit for what we want to do here. You know, football-wise, there's plenty of coaches out there that knows X's and O's, but if we're not touching the hearts and minds of our players and getting them to play hard, those X's and O's not going to matter at all. So, but it's got to be the right fit. If not, it's not going to work. If we're not a tight group as a staff, we can't expect for our players to be a tight group. And it's got to be that way. For me personally, I want an egoless staff. I don't have a lot of time for a lot of egos. You know, it's not about the coach, it's about our players. You know, so we got to make sure we get those kind of guys when it comes to putting together staff. Good people. Going to be really good people.
Coach, I was hoping you could tell us maybe a little bit more about Christian and Robert, what you think they might bring to the table and what the last 2 weeks have been like.
Beef. Both of them are winners. You know, Christian just played in a high school championship game. Didn't necessarily go his way, and kind of share the story with him how I ended my high school career the same way. You know, but he's a winner. You know, and kid with a lot of potential ahead of him. You know, he's a good football player with so much more development to come. And I think when it's all said and done, he's going to be a special kid. And with Robert, he's a big guy with quick feet, you know, that can run around. And I remember going into his home, and mom had a nice dish on the table for it. I felt like I was back home eating some nice soul food. It was like, wow, you know, just nice. And then seeing old Christian over there just eating himself. He had a nice sized rabbit over there just eating it and just going running through it. I'm like, yeah, this is my kind of guy right here, you know. And his dad was like, there's a reason why he got quick feet, coach. You know, so, but it was cool to see it. But more importantly, it was really nice to see the passion they have for Florida State University. You know, and guys, again, that wanted to be here. You know, and as a coach, that I can say that's, you want that more than anything because you know those guys are going to give you everything they have to be successful.
And also, I'm just wondering, what's the next week like for you? Are you planning to be in Shreveport or on the sideline, in the box, or elsewhere?
Recruit, coaches and players. And yes, I will be at the game, you know, and then also get my family out here, and get the move here. So I'm going to get that knocked out before we get back on the road in the recruit process and try to have our staff completed by then. So it's a lot of work to be done. You know, enjoy Christmas and say hi to Santa Claus and probably catch a ride with him somewhere else.
Coach, I wanted to ask about Odell and the job he's doing leading the team. You know, what are your impressions of how he's doing? And is he taking kind of a hands-on approach? How are you kind of working with him to kind of, you know, help this team throughout this transition?
I'm letting Odell finish what he started. You know, he's done a great job. The kids went out and played with a lot of excitement and enthusiasm. And we got the results that we needed in the game, the last game we played. And again, you watch practice. Responding to him, and you can tell they love him and they care about him. You know, he's getting some good experience as well. But for me, I'm just sitting back evaluating everything and trying to stay out of the way as much as I can. You know, if I get some one-on-one advice or anything, then I'll stick my two cents in. But I try my best to stay back and just evaluate. And that's like the hardest thing ever because I really do want to get out there and just go. But best thing to do now is just let those guys do their job and try to finish it the right way.
And one asked about your taste in music after it gives you a little juice too. Who are some of your favorite artists? Maybe what was the last album you bought or who's somebody you probably saw on
You really want to know that.
Of course. I think some recruits would like to know that too, I'm sure.
I like Kodak Black. I like Clyde. So I've got a relationship with Clyde. I like Lucci. Those are some of the things that I'll turn on and get me going during the day. I can't tell you what they're saying, but I love the music. I love the beats and how it get us going, you know. Again, I just, something that's gonna get me going too, so.
Now we're gonna talk for two more.
Coach, with the late edition of Woodby last night, I guess, what kind of impact, if any, does that have with momentum on the recruiting trail, even momentum for you as a coach to get that boost? Does other guys take notice? Does that make that big of an impact?
It makes a big impact, just the quality of player that you bring in here, and you see a young man that again, that good as a football player that really wanted to be here, you know. So I think that says a lot about not only him but our university and young men that wanted to be here. You know, again, I think the momentum. Yes, I mean to get someone that caliber player in the program is always huge to get going. But I think again for us to get it here as a staff and the relationship that we build is what's going to help us finish this recruit class off the way that we want. I think it's going to, when it's all said and done, we'll have ourselves a pretty darn good recruiting class. But it's going to be the right guys and the guys that we want here and guys that want to be here. But again, it's Florida State University. And again, we're only fine. It's not how you start, how you finish. We're going to finish strong.
Coach, you already had some very impressive hires already. I know you're going to hire more, but give kind of the vibe of kids, you know, whether they signed or kids that you're working on or potentially could work on. Give me the vibe kind of in the Southeast or Florida or just all over the country, just what the vibe from the recruits are on these guys.
They're excited, you know. I mean, every last one of the kids wanted to know who we're going to hire, who we're going to bring in here. He went into the house, you know, and as we haven't hired many, but we have one hire, you know. But I do know when we go down to South Florida, everyone is fired up with the hire that we had. The players are fired up, the coaches are fired up. I think the guys that's coming, guys are going to be fired up about it, you know, because a lot of them have ties here in the state. They know a lot of the coaches, a lot of the guys grew up in the state of Florida, so they know the neighborhoods and everyone else that's around. So. It's exciting, and then folks are excited, we're excited, you know, and now it's going to be a matter of just getting them in here and working our tails off.